you did right there to you. Mm-hmm. Read in this book.
Amen.
Amen, somebody. You know, and it says here the free gift of salvation is made possible through Jesus Christ. His death on the cross and his resurrection from the dead. You know, salvation is available to all. Received by grace through obedient faith. You know, and no other way. And I said obedient faith. See, somebody said, well, I can faith. No, obedient faith. And we have faith that ain't obedient.
Amen.
You know, it says obedient faith. Obedient to what? Obedient to the word and the directions of God. You know, I like to break that Bible down. B is the B-I-B-L-E, you know, basic instructions before leaving this earth.
Amen.
Amen. Somebody. Sometimes I like to call it G-O-D. The book of G-O-D, you know,
amen.
God's, you know, God's orderly direction.
Come on,
amen. Amen, somebody. You know, that's what's in this book. You know, that's what's in this book. Help us, you know, not go back and get out and not go back. Amen, somebody. And move on to something better. You know, here he says in Romans 3 and 23, it simply says, all have sinned. And fall short of the glory of God. And here I believe that this is just the idea that man was made originally in the image of God. He was made in the image of God. He was then sinless. He had no sin. He had no sin until he sinned.
Amen.
In the garden, when he ate that tree of the knowledge of good and evil, up until that point, he had no sin. You know, no sinner is in the divine image. Why? Because sin is not divine. We can't. Man and God, they had no sin.
Amen.
He was divine, you know, until he separated himself from God.
Amen.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
And ever since then, we've been having a hard time.
Amen.
We've been having a hard time, right? Because we want everything we see.
Amen.
We feel like we got to do everything there is we do. You know. You know, even though, and how I know that, because I've seen a man homeless and stinking, you know, come up to a man with a suit on, telling him he got to get some of this.
Amen.
He got to get some of this. You know, something wrong with that picture.
Yeah.
You know, and then that man with a suit on would leave.
Oh,
right. Man, he homeless and stinking.
Amen.
But I gotta get what he got.
Amen.
We all right. See, we messed up.
Amen.
We messed up, man. We falling for the Holy Ghost. You know, yeah. And no sinner is divine in image. All have sinned, and to have their divine likeness restored, need to have their sins blotted out. Amen, somebody. Until this is done, they come short of the glory of God. Amen, somebody. Give me that scripture I gave you. What did I say? 2 Corinthians 7:10.
For godly sorrow worketh repentance to salvation, not to be repented of, but the sorrow of the world worketh death.
Amen. Amen. The sorrow of the world worketh death. And when we turn back to the world, that's what we're going back to. We're going back to suicide. Amen, somebody. You know, sometimes that's why we call it death on the installment plan. You know, we go back and die a little bit every day.
Yeah.
Amen, somebody. What else do we believe in? We believe in water baptism.
Yeah.
Jesus commanded that his followers be baptized in water as identification with his death, burial, and resurrection.
Hmm.
You know, and I don't think you can do that in a teaspoon.
Yeah.
And I don't think you can do that in sprinkling.
Amen.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
And what I'm going to show you why I don't think so, but the word says so.
Oh.
Okay? Because what I think, I'm real bad.
That's
not God. What God says.
Right.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
We believe that when a person is water baptized, it symbolizes the passing away of their old life and the beginning of their new life in Christ.
Mm-hmm.
And is essential. And salvation process being for the remission of sins. What's the remission of sins? For the forgiveness of sin. For the forgiveness of sin. And in Romans 6 3 and 4 reads, "Or do you not know that as many of us that were baptized into Christ were baptized into his death? Therefore we are baptized, we are buried with him through baptism into death, that just as Jesus was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so we should walk in the newness of life." Baptism is a burial.
Yes.
You know, that means you got to go under. You know, you don't see nobody buried on top of the dirt. They got to go under. Amen, somebody. You know, and therefore it's the subject has to be dead. It has to be dead. As Jesus died through sin, we died to sin. As the crucified Christ was buried, we would have died to sin through the gospel. Our burial. Our burial with him. As death and burial separate from the natural life, so death to sin and burial into Christ should completely sever our relationship to sin. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Amen. We are made a new creature.
Yes.
We get a brand new start. You know, we get to start over. He will blot out your past sins. You know, that you get a new start. You know, and that's what he did for me. That's what he did for me. He gave me a new start. I took a brand new start.
Amen.
I took a brand new start.
Amen.
People say, sometimes they say you should never say no, but God told me he gave me the power, he gave me the spirit of Christ.
Right.
You know,
yes,
I don't have to go back because I choose.
Amen. Amen.
I don't have to go back. Why? Because I've had a taste of the this glorious life.
Amen.
And he blessed me to have a chance to live on both sides of the fence. And I can tell you this side is better.
Amen.
Amen. Even when I'm just walking around with pennies, I'm okay.
Amen.
You know, and he says that the glorious power of the Father lifted up Christ from the tomb. So we too rise from the watery burial with death and burial between us and the old life of sin to walk in the newness, walk in the newness of life. Brother Jenkins, read Acts 8:36-39.
Your mind is not very long.
Yeah, start by the Bible. You teach.
In Acts 8:38, starting at verse 35, we read. Then Philip opened his mouth and began at this scripture.
Mm-hmm.
Preached Jesus to him.
Amen.
Now as they went down the road, they came to some water.
Mm-hmm.
And the eunuch said, "See, here is water.
Mm-hmm.
What hinders me from being baptized?"
Yes.
Then Philip said, "If you believe with all your heart, you may." And he answered and said, "I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God."
Yes.
So he commanded the chariot to stand still. And both Philip and the eunuch went down to the water, and he baptized
them. Amen.
Now when they came up out of the water, the Spirit of the Lord caught them away, so that the eunuch saw them no more, and he went on his way rejoicing.
Amen. Amen. And the eunuch was an Ethiopian official. You know, the treasurer. He was a treasurer. And like, I don't know, it doesn't say nothing else about him, but somewhere around the line, Ethiopians all of a sudden start putting on Christ.
Amen.
You know, I like to believe that he went back and started preaching Christ.
Amen.
You know, why? Because that leads into the next thing we believe. We believe in the Great Commission. Why do we believe in the Great Commission? We believe that it is the mission of the church to advance the kingdom of God by making disciples of all nations, of all people, through the preaching and the teaching of the gospel of Christ. It is the responsibility of every believer to carry out the Great Commission. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
You know, how do you think it was started 2,008 years ago, John, to us today?
Okay.
You know, ain't no 2,080 old people walking around. So, the past, come on, come on. you know, you got to tell somebody.